Howdy, y'all.
It's Jordan Smith. I'm out here at Monarch Woods on a 40 kilowatt Tesla solar roof. Underneath me, I've got six Powerwall 3s that we're going to be talking about in a future video. But today, I want to show you sort of good news, bad news. The good news is we're back up on the roof. We've already got it installed. We have the Carlisle underneath. I've got another video coming out where we show all of the install part of it. But today, I want to show how easy it is to troubleshoot. So underneath here is where our mechanical room is and where all of our electrical runs into the Powerwall 3s. And we were testing all of the strings, and we could tell that one string wasn't producing what it was supposed to, which is the bad news. The good news is, look how easy it is to troubleshoot. So we were able to just pop these up. This is where it all comes through. We're able to measure the strings, and we know exactly where the potential problems might be. And then you just flip this up. You pop it up and you flip it up, just like the hood of your car. And you're able to test here. You see that they're moving over here. They're seeing if it's this string here. And then they're able to pop this one up. They're going to pop one up over there. So it's super easy to test and troubleshoot if you have a problem. You've got that 2-inch air gap underneath. If you watch my other videos on air gaps and roofs, this one really shows how the ideal way of it is. We have this 2-inch air gap underneath this whole roof. So we have our whip, our roof membrane there, have all our electronics on top of it, and a 2-inch air gap that keeps everything nice and dry. It's able to dry out, it's fully ventilated. The way that this roof is designed is really cool too. So we're on a 212 pitch that way south. So our sun comes up over here and goes down over there. This is fully exposed to the sun in summertime. Wintertime, it's going to be more over here, but we still get good sun coverage, and we don't have a single penetration on this whole entire roof. All of our penetrations are coming out of the walls. Comment below if you want to care or care about how that works, but all of our penetrations go out the wall. We don't have anything out the roof, making a nice huge area to produce electrical. These tiles down here are not powered. They are just passive. So this whole roof here is just passive, and these here are passive. We start making electrical up here. I don't know that you can tell the difference between those. You can sort of see those squares. So passive, active, super cool that it all looks the same. So I am a huge fan of the Tesla solar roof. We'll see what I think about the Powerwall 3s. I think I'm gonna like them a lot. We just have to see. I haven't ever done any of this with Tesla before, so it's literally my first rodeo in a lot of ways. But the roof components, the fit and finish is just great. It's just so much better than anything else that I've seen on the market. So I'll keep you posted on the batteries once we power everything up, commission it. Tomorrow we'll do another video, a little more formal video with a bigger camera. But I just wanted to show y'all what we're doing up here on the Tesla solar roof. I think it's super cool. Thanks so much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, do all your good stuff on YouTube. We really appreciate it. And we'll see you next time on Smith House.